सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 29। इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव अ रियल वैल्यूड फंक्शन एफ डिफाइंड एज एफ एक्स इक्वल टू 1 + b² टाइम एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 2bx + 1 वेयर बी वी ए एनी रियल नंबर एंड गिवन एम बी बी द मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ दिस फंक्शन एज बी इज द वेरिएबल। नाउ हियर वी विल फाइंड द रेंज ऑफ एम बी दैट इज सेट इन विच माई एम बी lies. Okay, now for the maxima and minima, firstly we will take the derivative of f and equate it to 0. So when we take derivative, then we have f dash is equal to 2x time 1 + b² + 2b, and when we equate it 0, then we have x equal to -b/1 + b². Now take the second derivative. When we take second derivative, then we have f double dash is equal to 2 times 1 plus b square. And we know this value is always strictly greater than 0 for any value of b. So this implies over point x equal to -b/1 + b² is the point of minima. That is, at this point function has minimum value. So when we compute the minimum value of function, then we have f minimum equal to 1 + b² time b² / 1 + b² to the whole square -2b² / 1 + b² + 1, as putting x equal to -b/1 + b² in the given function. So when we solve this one, then we have minimum of f equal to 1 upon 1 plus b square. And the in the question, minimum value of function is defined by mb. So we have mb equal to 1 upon 1 plus b square. Now it is clear that for any value of b, 1 upon 1 plus b² is always strictly greater than 0 and less than and equal to 1. That is, our mb will be strictly greater than 0 and less than and equal to 1 for any possible value of b, that is for any real value of b. So here range of mb is open interval 0 to close 1. That is, our option A is correct. Solution of question number 31. In this question, we have EB a non-empty subset of R and defined as E equal to sec of π/4 cos² x, where x can be any real number. And we will tell about set E, that is, set E is bounded, compact, open, connected, like that. Okay. So firstly, we will define our set E. Now, if we consider a function f defined from R to R and given as fx equal to sec of π/4 cos² x, then E set is nothing but range of my function f. So to redefine the function, set E, we will find range of function f, which is defined as fx equal to sec of π/4 cos² x. Okay, now, so in the sec, here our theta equal to π/4 cos² x. So firstly, we will find the range of this theta. Now we know cos square x lies between 0 and 1. That is, cos square x is greater than and equal to 0 and less than and equal to 1. Now multiply this by π/4. Then we have π/4 cos² x lies between 0 and π/4. That is, in the sec theta, our theta lies between 0 and π/4. Now our sec is increasing in the that is, when theta lies between 0 and π/4, then our sec function is increasing. So minimum value of sec will be at 0 and maximum value of sec will be at π/4. That is, we have range of function is closed interval 1, √2. So this by using so in fact we have our set E equal to closed interval 1, √2. Now it is a clearly closed and bounded interval, so it is compact, and it's an interval, so it is connected also. So we have here our option A, B and D are correct. C option not true, because here 1 and root 2 are the elements of set E, but they are not the interior point of set E. ओके, सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 32। इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव अ लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑन R3, दैट इज TBMF फ्रॉम R3 टू R3 विच बी ए लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड डिफाइंड एज टी एट एक्स कोमा वाई कोमा जेड इक्वल टू 2x, 4x - y, 2x + 3y - z। नाउ वी विल टेल अबाउट टी एज टी इज नॉन सिंगुलर, टी इज ऑन टू, टी इज डायगनलाइजेबल एंड एल्जेब्रिक मल्टीप्लिसिटी इक्वल टू ज्योमेट्रिक मल्टीप्लिसिटी फॉर ईच आइगन वैल्यू ऑफ टी। नाउ फर्स्टली वी विल चेक फॉर ऑप्शन ए एंड बी। ओके, नाउ फॉर द नॉन सिंगुलरिटी ऑफ टी, टी मस्ट बी 1 1 एंड ऑन टू, एंड फॉर द 1 1 विल कंप्यूट कर्नल ऑफ द टी। सो नाउ वी नो कर्नल ऑफ टी हैज सच काइंड ऑफ 3 टूपल सच दैट टी ऑफ दैट 3 टूपल इक्वल टू 0, दैट इज कर्नल ऑफ टी हैज एक्स बिलोंगिंग टू आर क्यूब सच दैट टी ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू 0। नाउ टी ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू 0 इम्प्लाइज 2x - 4x - y, 2x + 3y + z = 0, 0, 0. सो दिस विल इम्प्लाइज 2x = 0, 4x - y = 0, and 2x + 3y + z = 0. सो वैन वी सॉल्व दीज थ्री इक्वेशंस देन वी हैव x = y = z = 0, दैट इज कर्नल टी हैज ओनली 0 एलिमेंट। सो दिस विल इम्प्लाइज टी इज 1 1, बिकॉज वी नो एनी लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन विल बी 1 1 इफ एंड ओनली इफ इट्स कर्नल हैज ओनली 0 एलिमेंट। ओके, नाउ हियर सिंस TBMF फ्रॉम R3 टू R3 विच इज 1 1, सो दिस विल इम्प्लाइज टी इज ओन टू ऑल्सो। सो हियर वी हैव टी इज 1 1 एंड ओन टू, सो दिस विल इम्प्लाइज टी इज इन्वर्टेबल, दैट इज टी इज नॉन सिंगुलर। सो हियर ओवर ऑप्शन ए एंड बी आर करेक्ट। नाउ फॉर द ऑप्शन सी एंड डी, फर्स्टली वी विल कंप्यूट द मैट्रिक्स रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ टी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू स्टैंडर्ड बेसिस ऑफ आर क्यूब, एंड वी नो स्टैंडर्ड बेसिस ऑफ आर क्यूब इज 1, 0, 0 एंड 0, 1, 0 एंड 0, 0, 1। नाउ टू फाइंड मैट्रिक्स रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ टी, firstly operate these basis vectors on T and whatever we have vectors then write down these vectors as a linear combination of these standard basis. So when we do this then we have T at 1 0 0 equal to 1, 4, 2 and this expression can be written as 1, (e1) + 4, (e2) + 2, (e3) where e1 equal to 1 0 0, e2 equal to 0 1 0 and e3 equal to 0 0 1. Similarly, we can write as t at 0, 1, 0 and t at 0, 0, 1. So, by observing these, the matrix representation of t is equal to first column will be 1, 4, 2, second column 0, minus 1, 3 and third column 0, 0, 1. Okay, so this is the matrix representation of T. Now, the eigenvalues of these matrix are the eigenvalues of our linear transformation T. So, when we compute the eigenvalues of T, in fact, when we observe this matrix, then it's a lower triangular matrix. So, it's clearly its eigenvalues are nothing but the diagonal elements. So, the eigenvalue of T are 1, 1 and minus 1. So, here we have two repeated eigenvalues and one distinct eigenvalue. So, here algebraic multiplicity of minus 1 is 1 and hence its geometric multiplicity also be 1. And algebraic multiplicity of 1 is 2. Now, we will find geometric multiplicity of this eigenvalue. And we know geometric multiplicity is nothing but number of linearly independent eigenvectors corresponding to repeated eigenvalue as 1. Okay. Now we will find eigenvectors corresponding to eigenvalue lambda equal to 1. So to compute this, first take A minus identity time x equal to 0. So when we solve this system, then we have 4x - 2y = 0. And 2x + 3y = 0, that will implies x = 0, y = 0, and z can be any real number. So that is we have only one eigenvector corresponding two repeated eigenvalues at 1. So geometric multiplicity for lambda equal to 1 is 1. So this will implies C D option is not true. And also we have only one eigenvector with respect to two repeated eigenvalues as 1. So this will implies T is not diagonalizable, because we know T is diagonalizable if and only if T has n linearly independent eigenvectors, where T be a linear transformation from Rn to Rn. So our options C and D not true, and only option A and B are true.